let's focus on moving into the next topic, which is Jamal Crawford. Of course, Jamal Crawford has a deal. Well, he bought some the Ball family fortune. Of course, everybody know who the Balls are. You know, you got Lonzo Ball and his dad, the loudmouth Ball. So there is a situation where Crawford is now in a position where he might very well be thinking about taking working on a deal where he will be basically a promotion man or buy stock in the company, according to the report that he's supposed to be buying stock in the company. And he will be wearing some of Lonzo Ball's sneakers. And the curious part about that whole endeavor was the fact that there was an exchange I found very interesting about it on ESPN earlier today, which had Jalen Rose and, of course, commenting on it, and Michele Beadle, as they commented on Crawford's idea of possibly Pelicans getting in Jordan to the Crawford shoe game has been with Lonzo Ball, and this is and what she said.
Bless his heart.
In the Big Baller brand, he has interest in the brand. I don't really know exactly how else to phrase that.
I have interest in the brand.
What does this mean? Is this to you a meaningful story?
Well, I mean, it shows the young man has poor taste, number one. But more than that, if this is a move, like Jalen said, to get his name, and then fine, then I get it. But this is not a company that I would necessarily want my name associated with. As much as we joke and this and that, it is still, at the end of the day, a company that was rated by the Better Business Bureau a few months ago with an F, because every single complaint was negative. They did not have one correspondence that was positive. They can't send their merchandise out. They take the money and they run. You can't get a hold of anyone to get back. Why would you want your name associated with this brand?
There are so many companies on the face of this earth that get poor ratings. We still patronize.
That's different.
Also, as long as we're talking about the Big Baller brand, an independent company, it's a win for them.
I don't agree with that.
They're not Nike. They're not Adidas. We're discussing them. That's a win. Jordan Crawford, little brother from Detroit. This is a genius move by him. Guess why? We're talking about him.
But that
otherwise,
doesn't
give him a job. We would
not be. But that doesn't further his career.
We're talking about him.
All right. That's some of the interviewers you heard with those guys talking about the Ball and the fact that the bad business rating and all this kind of stuff. And that's true. But, you know, I like the way Jalen Rose defended the Balls. Now, of course, this is not a thumbs up to people that's doing bad business, you know, but he's right. They do have a lot of bad businesses that we go to and that we give a lot of money to. Case in point, they have some of these ridiculous snotty jeweler people out here that sell these jewels and all these different diamonds and all this jewelry at ridiculous prices. When you go in the establishments, they pretend like you don't exist. And that's a technique that they use to up the sales. You know, well, only a certain kind of clientele can be in here. We're not going to pay attention to you. We're not going to ask you if you need any help. It's just bad. They're taught to give you what is interpreted as bad service, but they plan on your insecurity. So if you feel insecure, well, they're not going to pay me. I'm going to show them I'm going to spend a lot of money earning their respect. Don't fall for that nonsense. Just kindly walk out of their stores and go to a store that shows you respect. Do not support or go to businesses that don't show you any respect when you walk in the door. I don't care what color they are. Bottom line, if they can't treat you with respect when you come in, do not respect them by giving them your money. Bottom line. And the fact that I want to talk about Beadle, what she's saying is absolutely right. I don't like her snotty attitude about how she delivers the message. The little smirk she made before about this, like she anticipating that the man business would fail. I would like to hear her stance on what she thinks about some of these other ridiculous shoe companies. Of course, Lonzo Ball shoes are cost too much, in my opinion. Yeah, they're too expensive. They are. But are you saying that about the rest of those expensive? Because his shoes fit in the same line with some of these other shoes that's out here. Did you say anything bad about Gucci? If they have tennis shoes, that's $400, $500, $600. If their shoes are priced way above what they're supposed to do only because their stamp is on them, Did you say anything about that? Or some of these other shoe companies or manufacturers that use, and if you go into the Asian nations, that's using Chinese sweatshops to build their shoes and make a profit. Are you making any negative commentary about them? So be very careful, because you're getting a little too comfortable. Be very mindful and careful of the territory you tread, because you could say the wrong things, because it's still a black business. And a lot of black people get real uncomfortable when they have other people other than them critiquing their business structure in that manner. So be very mindful of that. Just telling you.